Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video, we'll be looking at some of the tools I made when I was an apprentice. And on the lathe, I'll be changing over my X and Y readings on the digital readout. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. A few weeks ago, I showed you some of the things we made when we were an apprentice. And I've just been looking through some of the other stuff I made. I thought I'd show you some of the things that are still here 50 years after I made them. This is a cast iron block, and we used the shaper to remove some material from the bottom to form 4 feet. It's a 6-inch square block of cast iron. The top originally was just machined on the shaper, and then it was ground flat, and I still use that on and off these days. To go with that, we made a scribing stand block so you can adjust just the height, hold a scriber in here to mark things out. Nowadays I tend to use it to hold the dial indicator, and that fits nicely on the cross slide of the lathe, so you could use a dial indicator on an object in the lathe. We also made a set of G-clamps. A pair of pliers. These are made from scratch, just square pieces of steel, and you cut them out, machine them. Simple spanner. And I found this in an old toolbox, which is a screwdriver, or will be. I can finish this one off. You see the blade has just been roughed out. I have 3 other blades here that have roughed out. The idea is you just undo the end of the screwdriver and you can remove the blade. This has a square hole in it, machine body, a bore. That goes inside, the blade goes in, and you just tighten up the end. We also had some V-blocks, which I've used, but they're starting to go rusty again. This size of V-block. This was mainly done on the milling machine. And I think most people that had an apprenticeship in the 70s, 80s, probably made the same tools. Over at the lathe, and the scribing block, I fitted a dial indicator into it, and it fits nicely on the cross slide on the Boxford lathe, so you could check run out of a bore. That's the scribing block used on the lathe to check bore run out. If you're wondering what this is here, this is just a tin with oil in and there's a brush on the end of the cap for use on the lathe when you're cutting, and it's held on the end of this. This is my scale for the y-axis. It's held on the end just with a magnet on here. It just holds it in there. I'll take this off. Take the cover off. So what we have is the scale here for my y-axis, across the lathe, and at the back on the bed of the lathe I have a scale for my x-axis. I had a comment a few days ago from somebody who watched the video I did a few years ago about fitting the x and y-axis on the lathe, and asked me why I'd got mine opposite to normal. So on this video I'm just going to show how to put it back to correct, or how to change it to conventional. It's not important, you can use whichever one you want. The only time it becomes important is if you have a CNC machine and you're using your lathe on a CNC program with stepper motors, and what that will do is put the axes out, so when it thinks it's moving the x-axis it's actually moving the y-axis. So if you want it for CNC operation you need to get the x and y right. If it's just for manual use you can set it as you like. But what I want to do is change this over now to set it to the same as a milling machine, so it makes it a bit easier when you use one machine then go to the other machine, the x and y readings are the same. This is a cross slide, which should be y-axis, but as you see it's coming up on the x, and this is the going up backwards and forwards along the bed, which you can see it's got moving the y. So all I have to do is change the two sockets over at the back of the digital display, and there's another couple of things I need to do at the same time, because I have this in diameter mode, which gives me the diameter of the workpiece rather than a direct reading. So first of all we'll change the sockets on the back. Read out round, and we're looking at the back. All I need to do is undo the screws for the sockets. And swap them round so that the bottom one will go into the top and the other one goes there. I'll turn it back round to the front and I'll take the plastic cover off at the same time so you can see easier. To change the axis from diameter to direct reading, you switch it on holding the button down on the front here, and it goes into setup mode and asks to select a type. Using the up and down arrows, you can have direct, R&D, dial, change your resolutions, subdatums, put into slope mode, axis type, step mode,
angle mode, error, lathe mode, display, and clear all, or quit. So what I want to do is put into R&D, which is radius diameter, and enter. It's saying select the axis. Now because I've changed them round, I want the Y axis, which is the cross slide. So I want to select Y, which is by 1. That's not selected, that's selected. If I wanted X, I put that there and just put 1 on there. So I've selected that, enter, enter. Move back up again to select direct for the second axis, enter, select axis. Now this time I want the X axis as 1, which it's already set up to. Press enter. So the X is direct, which is if it moves a millimetre, it gives you a millimetre readout. So I'll come out that now, just go through till you get to the bottom, which says quit. Enter. Testing the DRO readout. So the first thing I want to do is move my compound slide to zero position to take out any backlash. Then touch my tool post onto the end of the spindle. And zero my axis. X-axis to zero. Then do one complete turn of the compound slide. The compound slide is pushing on the spindle, moving the x-axis back to zero. On this lathe it's 2.5 millimeters. It's about there. And you can see it's saying to 2.5 millimeters. So it's not doubling up the reading. So I know this is reading correctly now. And set this to zero here. Your Y is turn the Y axis, which you see
cross slide
in one revolution on the dial. If you move your tool in a thou, you're actually taking 2 thou off the diameter, and this is showing you what the diameter would be. Okay, I've set the dial indicator up in my tool post, and all I'm doing is using the dial indicator to represent the cutting tool. So what you do to set your scale, you just bring your cutting tool in till it touches the part. Obviously with a cutting tool I would use a feeler gauge between the tool and the part to get the feel. So you bring your cutting tool in. I'll set this at zero just for example. And then on your digital readout, and I've put in a size of 10.5, that's the diameter of the bar. And then move your tool over to what you're going to cut. You can put a cut on. Keep taking cuts until you come down on your digital readout. So if I was cutting that bar at 10.8, I want it to finish at 10.5.
I'm just looking at the readout and not the dial indicator.
I'd turn the tool in until it was there, and that's nearly 10.5.
And looking at the dial indicator, it is on size. You just need to remember not to change your tool position or turn the tool in the tool holder, or you lose your datum. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope it was interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.